it's taken away the need to be talented. So if you can take anybody off the street who looks right, you can put them in a studio, record their vocals. Next thing you know, you've got a million-selling artist.
Let the story begin. 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 This is anti-auto-tune. Death of the ring.
Music has been around for as long as we can remember, and has remained for many people a source of enjoyment, passion, and a way of expressing yourselves. There are many different genres and subgenres of music that define a person's personality and where they come from. In this documentary, we will be exploring how music has changed over time, and a variety of aspects that may have influenced this, including talent shows and autotune.
There are my reflection. Why am I doing this to myself?
To gain the ultimate answer of is music now about money over passion? Created by Andy Hillbrand, Autotune saves us from our mistakes. This was created in 1995 when Hillbrand used the algorithms made by oil companies to find drill sites through the use of seismic waves. This was then tweaked in 1996 and the Autotune software was born. The first example of its use was in 1998, originally thought to be Cher's Believe, when in fact, it was actually Tupac's California Love, which was an internationally admired song.
Autotune is one of those ones, it's a modern, when it first came out, it was like, oh, okay. You might have a great performance on a vocal, particularly when it was more tape based, that you know, you had great performance, but there might be one thing in it that just pricks your ear. Then I think it becomes an invaluable tool, actually.
In our first album, Black, we had a producer who was listening to some of our tracks and decided that some of the vocals weren't good enough, a bit wavy. So he suggested we use autotune. He mucked around with the tracks, then we listened to it back and decided that actually we didn't like it. It levels everything out, it takes out all the feeling.
As of 2019, autotune has rapidly increased as a hugely popular tool within the music industry, making music genres such as pop and rap very popular.
Motorsport, yeah. Put that thing in sports.
This gives the opportunity for anyone to use this tool, whether they are good or not, to manipulate their voice. The heavily affected pitch of auto-tuned vocals in pop music has led to much controversy among musicians and listeners. Singing, which was once a skill, can be done by pretty much anyone now.
It's a very useful get out of jail card occasionally. I think the issues with it sometimes is that it's used quite lazily, you know, or it can be a bit of a fix-all to not have to try hard to be creative. I think the same thing applies with regard to lots of other studio tools, be it compression or reverb or echo.
Many artists argue that autotune removed all the skill from singing, as well as destroying the minute accuracies that were the soul of many songs. The slight inaccuracies that made us so human in music have now gone.
Doesn't really help the music industry overall. Because what you're doing is you're taking away from the art and the ability of people. You're making it so that what's happening instead is you can pick anybody off the street that looks right and get them to sing. Because they don't have to have a good voice, they just need to look right.
This is both admired and hated by many artists. Big artists such as Travis Scott, Migos and Future support the sound and use it frequently in their music, as they feel this is more of a new movement and a form of art rather than the music itself.
I get those goosebumps every time. I need the Heimlich, throw that to the side.
There are some goods and bads to it. So like, especially for younger artists and also older, like who don't have the ability to like project the voice to certain tones, certain pitches, it can help with that and help them put forward the sound that they want their listeners to hear with their music.
In conclusion to the argument whether autotune has had a positive or a negative effect in the music industry, the younger generation's opinions conclude that it is an essential tool to create a good sounding song that will be popular with a wide audience. On the other hand, the older generation has said it is ruining modern music, with a negative view on autotune's use for anything other than minor tweak to a song's vocals. We have found that depending on your age and favourite genre of music, your view of autotune will vary.
Come on, girls, let's show them how we rock.
Modern talent shows have played a big part in both television and, furthermore, the music industry, as this has been used as an export method of producing musical talent, such as One Direction, Little Mix, and Olly Murs.
Come on. Come on. Go on, you can do it.
This isn't necessarily a positive, as this is often governed by the law and aren't true talent shows. Although these are not rigged, they can do a large amount to affect the overall outcome of the show.
I don't believe talent shows are rigged. I think they have a set of rules that regulate them that stop them being rigged. But I think that what the people are looking for who are in charge of the programmes are people they can sell. Now that might be selling TV, whereby somebody's interesting, somebody who's a bit mad, who looks interesting on TV, or it might be just that actually the person's got the right face. It has no relevance to whether they're talented or not. It's just how they think they can sell them.
This is what mainstream music has become. The image dictates financial success.
Chances are they are, just by the very nature of the fact that they're signing, you know, everything's buttoned up legally before you even get in front of the judge.
Contestants who have previously taken part have often complained that it's hard to adjust back to a normal everyday life after the show. This is because there is nothing set up to help them that allows them to make this change in a way that is beneficial. This is because they are no longer surrounded by cameras and press attention, forcing this change to be unhealthy and furthermore damaging their mental health.
The music industry is worse off for talent shows because ultimately now all you're getting is this ream of people coming into the market who are produced. They're not musicians, they're not people who have spent their life learning about music and writing music and have a passion for it. They're just people who want to be famous. They'll go on a talent show or they'll go on, I don't know, Countdown. They'll go on any program they can just to see themselves on TV and get on TV because they're interested in the fame, not the art of the music. And I think that's not a good thing for the industry.
I think it breeds a culture of, if I can just be good for this kind of thing and then seek these three people's approval, then I might have a career in music. It's a case of being able to have the confidence to plough your own furrow a little bit musically and hope somebody buys into it. Now it's much more, if I don't fit within these boxes, it's not going to happen. And I think that's a negative.
Overall, talent shows have been proven to be unsuccessful due to artists not being able to have full control over their music. This can make them feel under pressure, because the judges are presented as godlike figures who can crush or create a contestant's dream through the push of a button. Simon Cowell has made a fortune from the talent show business, with an estimated fortune of £225 million. The producers can change the song last minute, leaving the participant with a strong sense of anxiety that can have an enormous effect on their life. Why are these so popular?
But I think the belief that by ticking three or four people's boxes can be an entry into a career. Look at that. I think the results speak for themselves. You look at how many people go on those things and have a sustainable career. There's probably a couple, and that'd be where the Venn diagram meets, where obvious passion and talent have kind of coincided with it rather than because of it. But the rest of the time, it's what fits their current remit to sell some records at Christmas. And then 6 months later, they're out the door.
People are interested in the prize. Some people are. I don't think that's why most people go on it. I think it is more about the fame. The problem is that actually what people are doing is that the labels, the people in charge of the TV production, are interested in making money out of those people. Executives and music industries are making a lot of money out of these people in a very short period of time. They're not interested in them being successful. They 5-minute wonder, you know, make an album, make a song, sells a million copies, they make £1 million, next thing you know they've disappeared into oblivion. It's not about the prize money, it's just about being famous in your 15 minutes of fame.